everybody, this is Sean from The Verge, and I'm here at Tesla's design studio in Los Angeles, California, where the company just unveiled its first electric pickup truck, the Cybertruck.
Welcome to the Cybertruck unveil.
Now, we know Tesla has been working on a pickup truck for a long time, but in the years running up to this event, Elon Musk had said that this truck was gonna look straight out of Blade Runner. It was gonna have a cyberpunk aesthetic, and that he didn't really even care if people didn't like the design. Well, he unveiled a very cyberpunk, very Blade Runner truck tonight. The design is super polarizing. It really does look exactly how he said it was gonna look. Really does look like some kind of movie prop. One thing that could help Tesla move a truck that is as out there as the Cybertruck is the fact that the specs and the price actually sound pretty good. The Cybertruck starts at $39,900. That starting point is also lower than the price of a lot of the most popular pickup trucks on the market right now, like the Ford F-150 or the Dodge Ram. That version of the truck will get about 250 miles of range and be able to go from 0 to 60 miles an hour in about 6 seconds or so. Now above the base model, there's a dual motor version of this truck that's supposed to get about 300 or more miles of range, has a 10,000 pound towing capacity, and can go from 0 to 60 miles an hour in about 4.5 seconds. The top tier Cybertruck costs nearly $70,000, but Elon Musk promised it'll have at least 500 miles of range, which is outrageous. That's more than any other car Tesla makes right now, and almost as much as the second generation Roadster, which is supposed to be coming in the next couple of years. The whole event was really sort of a tease at the big automakers who make a lot of money from pickups. One of the things that he focused on was the fact that this truck is going to be made out of cold rolled steel, basically the same material that SpaceX has been using to build its Mars rocket prototypes. To show off how durable he thinks this is, he had Tesla's lead designer come out on stage with a sledgehammer and not only take it to the door of a typical pickup truck, but also to the side of the Cybertruck. And, you know, it didn't seem to make any dent, but a problem seemed to arise when they also tried to show off the strength of the windows on the truck, which are made out of a special metal glass. But when they took a big metal ball bearing to the windows, they broke. So obviously there's a little bit more to be done to make sure that this lives up to the sort of rugged standards that Elon Musk was promising tonight, but he took it in stride and kept sort of poking at the part of the auto industry that he really wants to disrupt with this product. Now, all versions of the truck will come with autopilot standard, the option to pay for the forthcoming full self-driving feature that Tesla's been promising for years. They'll all have 100 cubic feet of storage, which is a massive amount of storage and largely thanks to the really big bed in this truck. They have up to 16 inches of ground clearance with 4 inches of travel on either end. But Tesla didn't take much time to talk about the crashworthiness of this truck, and especially considering it's made out of this supposedly super durable, super strong steel, I'd like to see a little bit more about what's going to happen to other cars or pedestrians if and when this thing gets into a crash. Now, I actually got a chance to ride in this thing tonight. I was in the front passenger seat, one of 6 seats inside the truck. And one of the first things that struck me was just how big it is inside. Musk talked on stage about how by taking basically the structure of the car and moving it to the very outside, not worrying about paint or anything on the outside of the steel, he was able to open up more space inside the truck. And it certainly felt that way. It's hard to get a sense of exactly how big this thing is in person, but on the inside, it's clear that Tesla's making the most out of the room that they have available. There is a 17-inch touchscreen tablet, similar to the Model 3s, but a little bit bigger in the center of the dashboard that was actually running a new version of Tesla's in-car software that we only got a brief glimpse of. I like the design of it. I'm very excited to see more about that new version of the software and hear what Tesla has planned for it in the future. Honestly, the most striking thing about it is just how massive it feels underneath you. We don't know the spec on the battery in this, but the battery pack must be massive. You could feel how heavy it was underneath you as we were moving down the street. It certainly feels just about as fast as some of Tesla's other cars. We were in the dual motor specs of the mid-range one that starts at about $49,000. And I can only imagine that the top tier version would feel a little bit more ludicrous than the ride that we had tonight. I will say that if you're wondering at home whether this looks more or less polarizing in person, I'd say it's about dead on the money. It maybe even looks a little bit better in the renders. In person, it just feels very brutalist. It was honestly cold to the touch when I was getting in and out of the truck. And there is really nothing else like it on the market, which is exactly what Elon Musk says he was going for. Elon Musk is well known for not meeting deadlines on time or not living up to lofty promises that he makes. And I think a lot of people coming into tonight's event were trying to basically call him on the bluff. If the Cybertruck proved anything, it's that every once in a while, What Elon Musk promises is exactly what you'll get. Hey everybody, thanks so much for watching. If you love electric vehicles, especially ones that are a little bit polarizing, we just got to see Ford's Mustang Mach-E electric SUV a couple of days ago. Go check it out on our YouTube channel if you haven't yet. Thanks for watching.